my health, my responsibility, what a topic you have chosen on the science day. If there is health, then there will be divine thoughts and the thoughts at the upper level, which Dr. Abdul Kalam had said, dream on. And if you have to dream on, it should be with your eyes open. And if you want to dream with your eyes open, I would like to say that you should have a healthy mind and a healthy brain. So the first thing which I would like to tell is, just give me a second, next slide please. So you see, why you should listen to me? The first thing, just it looks a complicated graph, but it's very simple. In the world, when people tell you something, including me right now today, why should you listen to me? You see, it has been found out that if you see the journalist saying something, should you believe them? Politicians, civil servants, ordinary man and woman on the street, teachers and doctors. The people whom you should believe the most is teachers and doctors. Okay, so whoever talked on the dais from here today were teachers and they were doctors. And I myself am a teacher and a doctor. So whatever I am going to tell you, please believe me, and I have been there and done that. So you have some reason to believe what I am going to say today. Now, what is a responsibility? You see here, we are all talking about responsibility. I would like to tell you a small definition of responsibility. It is the ability to respond. Okay, if you have the ability to respond, then you can feel yourself responsible. As everybody was saying, whose liability is that? Whose responsibility is that? Who is responsible for my health? Who else can be except yourself? Think about it. So if you have the ability to respond, then you will be a responsible person. Having said that, let's come to the point. What is this all fuss about exercise? Do some exercise. Why this exercise is so important? Because today depression, as it was talked about, and deaths are mainly responsible due to lack of exercise. Now you see, you tell to your friends when you meet. What do you tell? When you just are departing from each other, you say, take care. I say, to hell with you. How can you say take care when you are not taking care of yourself? Are you responsible? Says you can take care of yourself. Think about it. We say to others, take care, but we are not taking care of about ourselves. When you don't take care about yourself, do you know how many people you are troubling? To your students, I will just ask you your favorite teacher. Who is your favorite teacher? Imagine your favorite teacher and see, has he been absent throughout the year to your class? No. How many times have you been absent in the class and say that my health was not good, I was ill? Think about it. This may be lame excuses or true excuses. But a teacher is never ill, and you are always ill, missing the classes. So don't tell, take care to others. Start taking care of yourself from here onwards. Here starts the journey of exercise. Okay. Next, please. So when you say, take care, are you really responsible for taking care of yourself? The answer is exercise. Some or the other exercise. What happens when you exercise? You see, what happens to your body when you work out? When you work out, there are at least four areas which are regenerated. Okay. I will put my talk in 30 to 40 minutes in three areas. The first is the physical part. What happens to the various organs of your body when you have some exercise? Now we have a myth that women should not exercise like men. Who says? We already have a super hit called Dangal, which was woman oriented. And we have many sports persons who are women. So whatever I am talking about applies to male and female colleagues both. So you see, what happens to your body when you exercise? Brain, then muscles, heart, and the liver. Apart from that, I would like to add the lungs. These are the areas, these are the organs which are very vital in your life. What happens with these areas, I will just summarize one by one. So I have three parts. One is what happens with your body. The second is the food. We just eat junk food. Whatever you eat, you will become. If you are eating junk food, you will become a junk body. Right now, we are a body of chemicals. See, for pleasure, there is a chemical. Boys would understand that. For pleasure, there is a chemical for girls also. You love to eat junk food, maybe pizza, burgers, etc., which is made up of chemicals. Boys, they search for pleasure, Coca-Cola or Sprite or whatever it may be, plus tobacco, alcohol, etc., drugs, chemicals. We are having chemicals for pleasure. We are having chemicals when we are ill. We want chemicals when to get fit. Means you go to a doctor, he gives you chemicals. So over the years, we have composed our body with chemicals. So how to come out of that? Exercise is the only way. So I will just tell you how to keep yourselves fit. If you see, these are the four organs. Just see, it's a cartoon how they are talking. This is the brain, these are the lungs, this is the heart, and these are the muscles. You have to reactivate them throughout your life to keep yourselves brain active, healthy, and whatever you want to become. That is, whatever your aims are there. That journey will suffice only with a healthy body. So you see, the brain is always lazy. You want to exercise, but you will never exercise the moment you think I want to exercise. So it will say to the other organs, you start. But they don't realize the activity, how it has to be done. You see, the muscles, it says, we forgot how to do that. The muscles will forget how to do the exercise. Okay, so it is up to your brain how to exercise. So what happens with the four parts of the body when you exercise? First, muscles. You see, oxygen is the most important thing which is required for your body, and it has to be given throughout, right from your brain to the toe. So muscles, they use glucose, they use ATP for contraction as well as the movement. And for ATP generation, you know very well, there is a large amount of oxygen needed. Okay, the proton motive force, the oxygen, these are all the driving forces for generation of ATP. And as soon as the pumping of the blood starts, the lungs, it collects the oxygen and supplies it throughout the body. And when your muscles, they start contracting and releasing, each and every movement requires ATP. From where it will come? It will not only come from your diet. You have to keep on moving. You have to keep on doing some or the other exercise. And as you keep exercising, I'll come to that also, which type of exercise can be done. As you keep on doing the exercise, your muscles will become stronger. Okay. And if you don't do that, a lot of lactic acid will be secreted and a muscle soreness, which is also called as the delayed onset muscle syndrome or the delayed onset muscle soreness. This will result and you will have knee problems, etc. post 40. So that is what we usually observe. So the muscles, take care of the muscles, you have to exercise. What type of exercise, I'll come to that. But see, this is the first part. For the sake of your muscles, get up and get going and do something. I have a saying, which is my own saying, and I'll show you in the end. I'm a cyclist. I love to do cycling. So in our cyclist group, we have a saying, we say, harkat karoge to barkat milegi. You just have to keep on moving. Okay, unless and until aap agar harkat mein nahi rahoge, to barkat aapko nahi milegi. Health ki barkat nahi milegi. This is one thing, muscles. The second thing, heart. There are a lot of things which you can think about the heart. It is the center, the fountainhead of all pumping systems in the body. This has been this heart has been the most villainous part in a youth. This is misleading you. My dear friends, all the students sitting over here, first of all think, come out of Bollywood. Heart never speaks. Mere dil ne ye kaha, mere dil ne waza, kuch nahi kehta hai. Wo sirf pump, blood pump karta hai. Aur agar usko blood pump karne ka aap kaam doge, to aap zinda rahoge aur acche rahoge. Yaad rakho, fir aapka jo ek galat fehmi hai, dil. You see, Bollywood is the villain there. Dil ke wajah se hi aapko sare problems hote hain aur baad mein dil ka hi attack aata hai, heart attack and death. There is nothing called as brain attack. There is nothing called as a brain attack and a person died in the middle due to brain attack, because brain is the organ which speaks. Heart will never speak. So be the masters of your brain and not the slaves of your heart. This is the message which I would like to give you. So heart rate which is there, the pumping, the more you allow your heart to pump blood. Don't listen to silly songs of all those nonsense people who are talking about dil ne ye kaha, dil ne hoga, mera aaj dil hi nahi keh raha hai. Kahan se kya keh raha hai? What is that nonsense? Okay, दिल को पंप करने लगाओ, ब्लड इतना पंप करने लगाओ कि आपके शरीर के हर कोने में ऑक्सीजन पहुंचे. हाउ टू डू दैट? यू कांट डू दैट विद अ सेडेंटरी लाइफस्टाइल. यू जस्ट कांट सिट देयर एंड से मेरे दिल को मैंने कह दिया हार्ट पंप करो. कुछ नहीं, अटैक करेगा आप मर जाओगे बैठे बैठे. थिंक अबाउट इट. ओके, सो नेक्स्ट ऑर्गन विच इज हार्ट, कम आउट ऑफ द नॉनसेंस. अलाउ इट टू डू वॉट इट इज सपोज टू डू. पंप इट. हाउ डज इट पंप? It pumps in two ways. See here, this is a beautiful picture. I'll come to this. Your heart, they in combination with your lungs, it pumps oxygen plus blood. You see, this is again a beautiful animation. The same characters, the lungs, it is saying to the heart, we have got you something, and it is giving oxygen molecule, and the heart says, I love it and I'm going to share it with everyone. So if your lungs can give to your heart the precious molecule of oxygen, then be assured that your heart will pump it to each and every organ of the body, and you will have more ATP, which means you will be more energetic in your life. So this heart has two-way pumping system, the left and the right. The left collects the blood, and the right, it goes on pumping the blood to the whole parts of the body, and you remain energetic. Come to brain. You see, what is this? These two are real-time images, a scanned image by Dr. Chuck Hillman, University of Illinois. He has taken the brain scan of two people, one who is sitting quietly for 20 minutes and the one who has been there after 20 minutes of walking. And you can see the hormones, the neurochemicals, the endorphins, which are secreted. What are endorphins? Endorphins are those chemicals which are secreted when you are in a state of panic. Means if I start running, if I start jogging, what does my brain sense? It senses that I am in a fear and I am trying to run for my life. Okay. So what happens when you are in fear? This is a positive reaction. What happens when you are in fear? Whatever the tensions you have, दुनिया भर के आपको टेंशन होंगे, अगर आप अचानक डर जाते हो और भागने की कोशिश करते हो तो पूरा आपका वो जो टेंशन है फॉर्मेट हो जाता है, आप सब भूल जाके भागना चालू करते हो. See, that is a very positive thing. So that is caused by endorphins, and this is a brain derived neurotrophic factor protein, which is the BDNF in conjugation with endorphin. So when you jog, when you work out, your brain secretes endorphins and all your tensions are formatted. Okay, the discomfort which is there, which you are the whole day, it will be erased and your brain starts anew, afresh. So that is the most important thing in your brain. See, we have talked about the muscles, then we have talked about the heart, then the brain, okay, the lungs, which gives you oxygen. There is one more beautiful study which has been done. What happens as you go on aging is that your brain shrinks in size, and that is responsible for Alzheimer's disease, dementia, forgetfulness, and everything which is related to aging. Okay. But if you can keep the brain size larger, literally I'm talking about a size, small brain and a large brain. Okay. Uska dimag chota hai. Hum bolte hain. Uska dimag bahut bada hai. Bahut fark hai. There is a difference when you are speaking about that. Okay, so science has proved, there is a paper here, Science Daily paper, exercise increases the brain size, it's according to a new research. So what happens when there is a exercise and how it is related with the size increase of the brain? Can I have the next slide, please? So the brain which is there, it is the centerfold of your life, and there are gray cells. There are cells which are responsible for activities, neurotransmitters, hormones are there, and the regular benefits of exercise when it comes to the brain. You see what is happening. So what happens? It enhances the blood flow through the brain. Exercises develops a brain which is larger in size, so you don't have Alzheimer's like diseases. Then regular exercise in children increases immunity. These are all scientific findings. I am not telling this on my own. Okay, it improves your concentration and attention, which you lack, maybe which you are lacking right now or you lack in the class. Okay, focus and attention. Then it, most importantly, the main important thing, it can change your gene patterns. What is this? See, this is very interesting area. If you exercise, you see, if your dad was a smoker, there is 90% of chance that the son will be a smoker. If dad was alcoholic, there is 95% of the chance that your son will be alcoholic. If mothers love the dirty pani puri, there is a 90% chance that your daughters will love the dirty pani puri more. Okay. I know you should be knowing about pani puri. There is a research paper in University of Illinois where they have found that Indian commodes hold cleaner water than the pani puri in the pot. Okay, that is true. Microbiologists, you know that. It's true. Enterobacterium is a family member, E. coli. How does it come in the pani of the pani puri when it has to be in your gut? Think about it. Okay, all these changes, it's related with health. Now, I was talking about the gene pattern. If this is the gene pattern which you are having, by exercise you can nullify that. You can nullify. If your dad was a smoker, you can become a non-smoker only by exercise. If your dad or grandfather was an alcoholic, you can become a non-alcoholic by exercise. You can change the gene patterns. This is something very remarkable. Try to understand that. So, many things are there. Neurotransmitters like endorphins, serotonin, dopamine, they are secreted. When you exercise daily, your brain, it gets a surge of blood. Blood rushes to your brain and you feel very, the brain formats itself into a cleaner hard disk so that you are reactivated for the rest of the day to work. And your body is to bone mass, it gets stronger. And the weight bearing, that is osteoporosis, usually the thinning of the bones or the bones becoming porous as you go on aging, that is nullified when you are doing some exercise. Now, exercise is also bound to show increase in the immunity levels. How does that happen? Increase in the T cells, decreasing in the stress hormones, and increasing in the insulin sensitivity of the lower the blood sugar has been found associated with very small activity like 2 to 3 kilometers of walking a day, not even for a whole week, but only for 5 weeks a day. You see, this is one research where when you just jog or walk, you have an increase in the natural killer cells, you have an increase in the T cells, the B cells. You see the graph which is there, it is increase, and only by exercise there will be an increase in the cells. Which type of exercise has to be done? You see, there are only 3 types of exercises. You can choose any one of them. One is the flexibility exercise, which is stretching and yoga. The second is aerobic, like the swimming, walking, cycling, etc. The third is the strength bearing muscles, for muscles you go to a gym and do that. You can choose any one of the exercise which suits you the most. Or if nothing else, just go for a morning walk for a couple of kilometers. That is fine. But sitting idle, having a sedentary lifestyle is of no use. So I have put this ABC of your exercise. A is be always active. Active. B is have a better beverage. Better beverage, no Coca-Cola, no Sprite, no thumbs up. Drink lots and lots of water, plus a glass of buttermilk, maybe, as he rightly put up. Okay, drink lots of water. C is choose calorie wise. How much calorie you are inputting? We don't know how much calorie one samosa or one burger occupies. You are students of science. I am privileged here to come and talk in front of an august audience who is 100% science. RLT College of Science, that is what I read in the very first onset. And that thrilled me. Because whatever I am going to say, you are going to understand. So, do you understand when I say choose calorie wise? I will show you what is calorie. Okay. So this is the difference which the whole generation today is there. It is a sedentary lifestyle, and sedentary means sitting head down in your mobiles with a hunchback and your brain completely dead without any physical activity. If I tell you to work for 2 to 3 hours, you will not be able to work without getting tired. Those who can work physically for 3 to 4 hours without getting tired are physically fit today. Okay, I love what Baba Amte and Prakash Amte, they say, buddhi cha vikas naisargik ahe, pan sharira cha vikas karava lagto. You need to work out your bodies. Who taught you how to handle the mobiles? Did you read the instruction manual for that? Definitely no. You didn't read the instruction manual. You just took it in your hands and got on learning. It's a self-learning process. You developed your brain on your own. But who is there to develop your body? Your health is your responsibility. The ability to respond to your health is yours. So, see, sharirik vikas, tumhalaach karava lagel. So, this is very important. Don't be sedentary. This slide I have modified into pictures. I will show you. Think before you eat. I will show you afterwards. But before coming to the next part, I would like to tell you, this is a scientific slide where 71 benefits have been backed by science. When you do a small exercise like couple of kilometers minimum, go 2 kilometers, come back 2 kilometers, around 4 to 5 kilometers if you walk daily, finish, nothing else. Okay, if you walk daily, there are 71 benefits, which starts with 30 minutes of your walking, then 24 hours, after a month, after 6 months, after 1 year, after 10 days, after 25 years. What are the benefits? And right now, I myself, I see that I am here. After 10 years, I am reaping the benefits. My age is, this March, I will be 50 years old. My age is 50. Means I will be entering the 50th year, and I would like to say that I have a long history of diabetes in my family, but by God's grace or my responsibility, with the God's grace, I have not a single visit to the doctor. Many doctors are my friends, but I don't go to meet them for that purpose. So I am healthy. You can take. That's what I said. Why you should listen to me? You listen to me because for 10 years I have been doing something, and from the past 5 years I have taken it to a new level. I'll show you some pictures of those also. So it all starts with the elevation of the mood, then becoming more productive, then becoming a quick learner of what you are doing, then you love what you are doing after 6 months, after a year you become stronger and you become a teacher and a preacher of what you are doing, after 10 you are not overweight, after 10 years you are not overweight, you look healthy, young and strong and energetic for the work which you are assigned to do, and after 25 years you will love to live longer and you will live longer. I always believe that what we pray to God, we say, give me this, give me that. You say, you give me wisdom. I say that vidya mango, koi fayda nahi hai, buddhi mango. Ayushya mango, koi fayda nahi hai, arogya mango. Vidya ke bigair, buddhi ke bigair, vidya koi kaam ki nahi hai, arogya ke bigair, ayushya koi kaam ka nahi hai. How to achieve that? By simple exercise you can do that. Okay, so what are the benefits of exercise? Many are there. Exercise, any exercise you can do. I have been talking about it. So you can choose. My suggestion to you is, do what you love. What do you love to do? I love cycling. You see, I never loved jogging. Or let me be frank with you, let me tell you, Ramdev Baba has done a revolution in yoga, but I never loved doing yoga or pranayama. That is my problem. It is a fantastic process. But if you love that, do that. Don't do forcibly on yourself. I never loved jogging, I never loved yoga, but I love cycling. And I have taken cycling to a new level. As I say, even at the age of 50 right now, I can tell you how much kilometers I do. And then club it with something which makes you feel happier. Okay, so this is me. I have been cycling for past 5 years. So as I come to the end of my talk, I would like to show you something which will interest you. You see, cycling, if you cycle for around 30 minutes, it burns 300 calories. Just note this down on the backside of your mind. And I will tell you how many calories you gain when you eat your regular junk food. Cycling does a lot of things. It manages depression, anxiety. It gives you a lot of happiness. Okay, I have been cycling. This is my cycling attire and I love it when I am on the roads. Okay, I will show you some more things also. It helps you build muscles. It helps to make your heart stronger. It helps your immune system, lowers the risk of heart diseases, protects you from cancer, because all the free radicals which are acting on your body, creating millions of cells, which your WBCs and natural killer cells are removing right now, they won't be removing when you are 40. So on whom will you rely on to remove those cancerous cells from your body? It will be only and only exercise. No wonder that the sedentary lifestyle of the youth, we are having cancers at a very young age, we are having diabetes at a very young age. Why? Because we are becoming more sedentary and the culprit is your mobile. Okay, anyway, think about it. Now you see, this is my all-time record, maybe a bit old. There is a beautiful app called as Strava. If you download that app, you can record your activities if you are cycling, you are going for a walk, jogging, you can choose anything, and your activities will be recorded. So if you see all-time record from last 4 years, means the first year I never recorded it, after 1 year I came to know about this app. In the last 4 years, I have cycled around 20,000 kilometers. Okay, last 4 years, you just can imagine how much I cycle, and I love it. 20,000 kilometers, some around 400 to 500 rides I have done, and the biggest ride, my biggest ride was 210 kilometers actually, from Parbhani to Tuljapur. Okay, later on I have done 200 kilometer rides many a times, but the largest was 210. Then we just went on joining some competitions, etc., because this is one which I love the most. And what happens when you go for a cycling? You see, you make friends. This is me, my students. This is me. This is one of my very good friend, Dr. Pawan Chandak, who is a doctor. And with him, I have associated into a social work also with cycling. I have rode 18,000 kilometers, and myself and Dr. Pawan Chandak, we contribute 2 rupees per ride to the HIV orphans of my region. They are HIV orphans, so we have clubbed it to a social activity also. Why that is so, I will tell you in the end. That gives us pleasure, that gives us happiness. 2 rupees per kilometer every ride. So what happens? The urge is to go longer, the urge is to do more rides so that we can contribute socially more. And 20-25,000 kilometers when we are doing it, and every rupee we donate it to the underprivileged children for some cause, that gives us immense happiness. This is my son. What happens now? See, my son never wants a bullet or a bike or some petrol driven vehicle. He has been seeing me cycling and he says, "Dad, I want to be a cyclist." That is one big thing which I could transfer to my next generation. He doesn't like a bullet. He doesn't like any petrol driven vehicle, he says, and he is with me on most of the rides. Seeing that, my younger daughter, who is now in 8th, she also accompanies me for the rides. You become an institution of your own exercise regime to your younger generation, but you have to do it. You have to do it to show it. And you see, this is my nephews, my whenever I go in my relatives, I am a very favorite cyclist Shiva uncle. Okay, they just love and we enjoy. Even on the roads, the people, they are very interested when we come from far, 50 kilometers, 100 kilometers. How do you do that? What is the cycle? Cycles are very simple. No big investments. 10-15,000, you can get a very good geared cycle. And you just can enjoy the rides. This is my perspective. The same somebody can say of jogging also. Same somebody can say of yoga also. The gist is to keep harkat karte raho, barkat mein raho. This is the more important thing which I want to tell you. Okay, so this is my ride to Mahabaleshwar, Pachgani. And there, you will be surprised how much the people, they help you when you are on the roads with such a long distance, with a purpose. We have boards. We put boards. Whatever the current situation is, we put the board. Beti Bachao, Beti Padao. Like this. You just go on. Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. Whatever the current issues are there, we put a small digital board on the throughout the cycles, and we just go on. It will educate people, and they will ask, they will inquire, they will felicitate you, they will welcome you, they will learn from you. Things go on, and you acquire new skills. This is during Pachgani, we had 5 punctures in 1 hour, and every puncture we repaired on our own within 3 minutes per puncture. We have become such skilled on the persons on the road. Not only we repair our own punctures, but we can repair our friends' punctures also. See, these are the skill sets which no college, no laboratory, nothing will teach you. This is how you have to acquire. So the thing which comes, now I'm coming to the final part of, means 10 minutes more. How much is too much? Now you should not do more than that. I have done, as I said, 200 kilometer, but I thought that that is too much for me. I done a couple of 200 kilometer ride, but that is too much for me. So the most important thing is, how much is too much? This is one data which has been given by David Neiman, a professor in the Department of Health in America. He has said that, why I am giving you this is, and this is a Vagbhat Acharya, he has written in Vagbhat Sanhita, the same thing. Ancient knowledge, latest knowledge. I will tell you what the thing is. Today, everybody, even when I'm entering Akola, I saw a banner, run for the trees or something, marathons. Everybody is organizing marathons. What should you do it? If you want to do it with preparation. Okay, because the more you do it, more you are exposed to the upper respiratory tract infection. Don't do it in a silly way. Don't do it because everybody is doing it. Do it in a moderate way. So in Warbat Sanhita, what does he say? If you overdo it, then ati vyayama mule trishna kshay swas rakta pitta shram glani khokla tapo vanti utpanna hotat. Mag vyayam kiti karava? Tumcha kshamate peksha nimme vyayam karava. If I can go for 200 kilometers, I should do 100 kilometers. If I can go for 100 kilometers, I should do 50 kilometers. Only half of your capacity if you do, then it will be more beneficial for you. This is a beautiful book. I would like you all to read it. And this book is freely available on the internet, the PDF format, The Sports Gene. There is a gene for sports. And if you don't have that gene for sports, as I said earlier, by exercise, you can develop a gene for your sports. There are many issues which are covered here. I will not go into details. But this is one fantastic book which explains how the gene, sports gene inside you can be activated and you can become a healthy person. So having said that, you see, the whole food nutrition and whole effort exercise, it has to be an exact combination of two to remain in a healthy fashion. You just can't do exercise, don't eat nutritious food, you will die early. And if you just keep on eating food and don't exercise, again you will die early. So what the problem lies, the solution lies somewhere in between. Have a whole food nutrition, have a whole effort exercise in a moderate way and dwell in the middle of this life and life will be beautiful. Now coming to the last part. We always love the junk food. Now I am going to show you pictures of some junk food where you will see how many calories those junk food are there, one thing, and second, how much you should run or walk if you eat that much of junk food. You see, one aloo paratha contains 329 calories and you have to burn those, you will have to run for 40 minutes. So one aloo paratha, run for 40 minutes. One pizza slice, I am not talking about the complete pizza, one pizza slice, you have to run for around 50 minutes because it contains 410 calories. Have you ever thought about that? Pasta, 131 calories, you have to run for 16 minutes. One KFC, Kentucky's burger, it contains around 500 calories, you have to run for 1 hour. If you eat one burger, if you run 1 hour, then eat it. If you have the capacity to run 1 hour after eating one burger, then eat it, no issues. But if you can't run it, why you are eating it? You are killing yourself, man. Think about it, what I am saying. You see, two egg omelets, 300 calories, burn it with a 36 minute run. I have burn to run and run to burn this equation. One packet Maggi, all the Maggi lovers, it contains 350 calories. You have to run for 45 minutes if you eat one packet of calorie. Can you do that? One dosa, we say it is a South Indian light fermented food. You have to run at least 15 minutes to burn one dosa. And a donut with a chocolate, all the bakery junk foods. You see the calories which you, 1 hour you have to run if you have eating one chocolate donut. Now rajma rice, 360, 42, momos, samosa. Favorite food. See, 308 calories, you have to run for 36 minutes eating just one samosa. Can you do that? If you eat one samosa, you have to run for 36 minutes. If you can do that, then it's fine. Similarly, Coke, as Deshmukh sir was saying, one bottle of Coke, 210 calories, you have to run for 25 minutes, you can't do that, believe me, because it is carboxylated, carbon dioxide is pumped in that, and we have a tendency to remove the carbon dioxide, it will not give you any calories, it will just kill you. The same thing, okay, you see the chocolates, this chocolate bar, one chocolate bar, walk for 42 minutes. But you keep on munching the chocolates without anything. And this is very specially for the young generation. If you want to be healthy, you have to burn. Okay, if you earn the calories, burn the calories. The same is applicable to all the foods which is there. So the list can go on and on and on. Coming to the final part, this is only two slides are there. Don't worry. Don't worry about this. I will tell you orally. Don't get horrified by the lot of matter which is there. This is actually a message which I sent to my friend. I'll tell you a small incident in my life which happened, and that is the last part of my talk. My friend, he was a very rich guy, goes to gym, has a very healthy six-pack ab body, and seeing me, my very good friend, a rich fun, see, I'm telling you, he was very rich, he was sensible in eating, he has a six-pack ab, muscular body. He comes to me one day, my schoolmate, a hunk, says, Shiva, I have everything here, but I am not happy in my life. You talk about exercise. I exercise. You talk about healthy, good food. See my muscles. I am very healthy. But I don't know why I am not satisfied in my life. And you seem to be very happy doing small things in life. How do you manage that? You see, if this is a book by Loretta Graziano Breeding, PhD. Again, this is available freely on the internet. You can download it. Meet your happy chemicals. There are four chemicals which only in combination will make you happy, and they are released in your brain. Which are those four chemicals? Dopamine, endorphins. Dopamine can be achieved when you are automatically happy, when you do something happy. You love ice creams, I show you ice cream, you get very happy, dopamine will be secreted in your brain. Lot of efforts is not needed. If you see your mom after 2 months and suddenly you feel happy seeing your mom, that secretes dopamine in your brain. You don't have to do anything. Endorphins. Whatever my lecture was there, it was all about endorphins. You exercise and you will secrete endorphins. But there are two chemicals which make you happy, and they are oxytocin and serotonin. How to release them? And the combination of these five chemicals will only make you happy. So I said to my friend, dear friend, you are very happy because you are rich and you can buy whatever you want, and you always keep secreting dopamine in your brain. A new mobile comes, he sells the old mobile at a throwout price and takes the one like iPhone X, and he is happy. Dopamine is secreted. Okay, fine. He goes to a gym which is 3,000 rupees per month, state of the art facility, and he exercises, secretes endorphin. He is okay, fine, fit and fine. But finally, why he is not happy? Because he is lacking in oxytocin and serotonin. How to secrete that? You see, when you become close to another human being, okay, oxytocin, when you hug your mother, when you hug your sister, what happens? When you become a close friend with someone, when you are not involved in fight with anyone, when you don't have hatred towards anyone, you have only love filled in your whole mind and body. That is responsible for secretion of oxytocin. That is what may be the compassion. If you are having compassion, then you will keep on secreting oxytocin. And serotonin is the only chemical which comes from social contribution. Social contribution has to be done. I will tell you today what my father always used to do. Tell. My father is no more in this world today, but he gave me a very good lesson. He said that make your hands like this. Just keep your two hands like this. And this is all what you need in your life. I said, Dad, what do you mean? He said that if you are hungry, this much water will be sufficient for you to drink, drive away your thirst, and you will not die. I said, I did. If you are hungry, this much rice or this much food is sufficient for you to keep you alive and not die. I said, I agree. He went on, become a bit humorous, and said, if you want to marry off your younger sister after me, this much gold will be sufficient, I think. I said, agree. Yes, this much gold. So God has given us two palms, make a cup of it, and that is all you need in your life. What will happen if it exceeds? If it exceeds, it falls down on the earth, on Mother Earth. And that is our contribution. Whatever is more than this has to be given to the society. You have to contribute to the society. And by doing that, you will be secreting serotonin. And serotonin is the main chemical which will keep you brain active. So how much you are contributing to the society? That's what I say, 2 rupees per kilometer ride. We contribute to the society and we try to keep our serotonin levels very active. So my friend got that. I hope you also get that. Okay, coming to the end of my lecture, here at this particular point, as I say, harkat karoge to barkat mein rahoge. I don't know how I find a cycle wherever I go. I just find it and I just ride it. This was a cycle by an ice cream seller, and he was so amazed by my mobile phone. So I gave him the mobile phone for some time to play with, and I took his cycle for some time to play with, and it is that ice cream seller who took out this photo. And some wise man had said, Actually, this was a sarcastic and arrogant statement, but I liked it. He said that if you want to make everyone happy, because you can't make everyone happy, don't be a leader, go and sell ice creams. I said, what's wrong in that? Yeah, good, let's do it. Okay, so this is what my message is. In the end, it should be a combination of everything. What everything? Few lines by Mubarak Siddiqui I would like to recite here and end my talk. How your life should be. It should be a perfect combination of exercise. It should be a perfect combination of food. It should be a perfect combination of divine thoughts. It should be a perfect combination of social contribution which you are indebted to. So what does Mubarak Siddiqui say? He says, Kamal hai. Aapki zindagi kaisi honi chahiye? Kamal ki zindagi honi chahiye. Kamal kis tarah se aayega? So see what the thing he says. Eight lines are there and I will end my talk. I would like to listen to this very carefully. This is one line, these are those lines which have inspired me a lot. It's in Urdu. My friends, those who understand Urdu will know the nuances and the fineness and the beauty of it. For those who don't understand, some few words I will explain it. Khiza ki rut mein gulab lehza bana ke rakhna kamal ye hai. Khiza ki rut mein gulab lehza bana ke rakhna kamal ye hai. Khiza means autumn, patjad jab hoti hai. To aise rut mein bhi gulab ki tarah khilte rehna kamal hai. Hawa ki jad mein diya jalana jala ke rakhna kamal ye hai. Hawa ki jad mein, the turbulence of the air, jad is the flow. Hawa ki jad mein diya jalana jala ke rakhna kamal ye hai. Zara si lagjish ke tod dete hai taluk zamane wale. What is lagjish? Lagjish is when I change my side. If RLT college is there, some another college is there, on the dais if I say that that college is better than this college, suddenly everybody will get angry. But I have seen that there is some point, accept it. Okay, so this happens with friends. We change the side and somebody gets angry. That is lagjish. Zara si lagjish ke tod dete hai taluk zamane wale. So aise vaison se bhi taluk banaye rakhna kamal ye hai. Kisi ko dena ye mashwara ke gham bichadne ka wo bhool jaye. Bichadne ka gham mane aapka jo faltupane ka bichadna hai wo nahi. Okay, bichadna kya hota hai main batata hu aapko ek 30 second mein ki main 2010 mein mere pitaji guzar gaye. 2002 में मेरे एक दोस्त के पिताजी गुजर गए थे. उसके घर मैं गया था 2002. And when I went there, I said to him that he had two sisters, younger sisters, which he has to marry off. So I said him, come on man, take care of yourself. You are the man of the house. Don't worry, you can do it. Now you are a responsible person and जिम्मेदारी से अभी आपको निभाना है. 2010 में मेरे पिताजी जब गए, वही भाई वही दोस्त मेरे पास आया. मेरे भी तीन बहने थे जिनकी शादी होनी थी. उसी वही बात उसने कहा मुझे, यू आर द मैन ऑफ द हाउस, डोंट वरी, नाउ एवरीथिंग विल बी फाइन. बट वाज़न्ट देयर अ डिफरेंस इन माय टेलिंग हिम एंड हिम टेलिंग मी? देयर डेफिनेटली वाज, बिकॉज एट दैट टाइम माय फादर वाज देयर एंड व्हेन ही केम हिज फादर वाज नॉट देयर एंड ही हैज बीन देयर एंड डन दैट. ओके, सो किसी को देना ये मशवरा कि गम बिछड़ने का भूल जाए, ऐसे लम्हों में आंसू अपने छुपा के रखना कमाल ये है. देन यू से ख्याल अपना, मिजाज अपना, पसंद अपनी. दिस इज हाउ वी लिव. जिंदगी कैसी जी रहे हैं हम? ख्याल अपना, पसंद अपना, मिजाज अपनी, कमाल क्या है? जो यारों को चाहे वो हाल अपना बना के रखना कमाल ये है. यू शुड लिव एज इफ अदर्स हाउ दे वॉन्ट यू टू लिव. ओके, last two lines, beautiful lines. You see the last part, serotonin part. This is kisi ki raah mein khuda ke khatir, kisi ki raah mein khuda ke khatir utha ke kaante hata ke patthar. Kisi ki raah mein khuda ke khatir, not for yourself, khuda ke khatir utha ke kaante hata ke patthar, fir usi ke aage nigaahein apni jhuka ke rakhna kamaal ye hai. Thank you my dear friends, thank you very much.